What's up, everybody? Anyextee coming to you today from Tanis, and I'm here with
Ezzat.
And Ezzat is what?
Tanis Victor, the oldest Tanis Victor here.
And he's famous. You can find him in the Lonely Planet guidebook.
My name is this book.
Okay.
Yes. It's the name of Egypt. If you read the Tanis, you will discover my name inside it. You can.
Yeah.
Yes.
Check
you.
Out the video. Hello.
Thank you.
Come on.
Today we change
it. You change it, like move things around.
And with the ground, Ramses the second, who was in the ground, put it here in the statue. Ramses the second here.
Yeah. Yeah.
You pulled it out of the ground?
Yes.
When? This year?
Well, yes. But we moved only in the top.
Ah.
In the ground.
What?
America.
I will explain everything for you and you.
Ezzat's passion is apparent. He loves to explain the reliefs in each stone, just as much as he loves bakshish, so tips are appreciated. Lonely Planet's guidebook to Egypt gives him a favorable mention, but says not to expect much in terms of history. But that statement I found to be inaccurate, as I found Ezzat to be a well-informed guide. He possesses a rich understanding of the site's known history, including both the history of archaeology and restoration. But much of Tanis's ancient history is indeed shrouded in mystery, with missing gaps that have not been sufficiently explained by academics. Ezzat does attempt to give us a brief history of the site, but the wind noise resulted in such poor audio recordings, and because Egypt doesn't make it easy for vloggers to use microphones or audio capturing equipment, I simply used my phone to bring you this footage. So, I will offer you some brief history for context here before we get into a hieroglyph by hieroglyph detailed tour of Tanis. A site in ruins, Tanis is a rarely visited site which most people have not heard of. And unless you have a police convoy clearing aside traffic for you, like we have, which may save about 20 minutes to an hour, the site takes 3.5 hours to reach from Cairo. Although we may offer excursions to Tanis through adeptexpeditions.com, it's usually not on most tour itineraries, but as mentioned, few people have ever heard of Tanis, despite it being the capital of Egypt since it became the seat of power in the 21st dynasty. While many may not recognize Tanis, if you have watched the Indiana Jones movies, there's a chance you've already seen it, as it was portrayed in the film Raiders of the Lost Ark. After the 22nd dynasty, Tanis lost royal status but became the 19th nome of Lower Egypt, and went on to experience several new phases of building which ended during the Ptolemaic period. It was then abandoned during Roman times. And in late antiquity, bishops of the Coptic Orthodox Church occupied Tanis, claiming all of its megalithic marvels. The name Tanis comes from Coptic Greek origin, but the modern Arabic name is San El Hagar, and has also been referred to as Nahuya, but the ancient Egyptians referred to this site as Janet. Some religious texts, such as the Old Testament, make reference to Tanis as Zoan, where the Hebrews would have suffered pharaonic slavery, or at least that is what some archaeologists believed, even though it may be confused. The city of Tanis is known for one of the greatest archaeological treasure troves ever found, on par with the treasure discovered within Tutankhamun's tomb in the Valley of the Kings in Luxor. The first serious study of Tanis was performed by Rosicrucians, such as Napoleon Bonaparte and his camaraderie of savants. It was first excavated in the 19th century, and work by the French mission continued at the site up until COVID. There have been some recent restoration efforts and excavations by the Egyptian authorities, some of which I had the privilege of seeing. It was not until the more recent discovery of Per Ramses, from where many of its megalithic stones have been carried over from, after originating in Aswan, that the place of Tanis was finally restored in the long chronology of the sites of the Delta. I have been coming to Egypt for more than a decade, and now that I live here, I have decided to take up study in the Middle Egyptian hieroglyphic language to learn how to read and write hieroglyphs under a PhD degreed Egyptologist. And I realize that there are many others interested in learning hieroglyphs, so I wanted to upload this video not only as an exploratory tour of the site, but for others interested in the hieroglyphic language as well, as a resource. So let's get into the tour as I take you through the site so Ezzat can provide an explanation glyph by glyph.
The ancient Egyptian name for this era was Janet, and it mentioned in the Bible, in the Torah, as Zu'an or Su'an. After Arabic name for this era was San al-Hakar. San al-Hakar, this Arabic name. But Greek name for this era is Tanis. Who called it Manitun? Who called it Tanis? Okay, and you can consider this name is the Greek name for this era, Tanis. Okay, we discovered here about the largest number of obelisks, about 23 obelisks in this area, 23 obelisks. But we lost many obelisks outside of Egypt and inside in Egypt. Like since 2 years, Egyptian mission moved from obelisks to Cairo. One in Grand Museum will be hanging, and one in Alamein, and one in Tahrir, and one in New City. Near capital, and the Egyptian mission moved the huge statue from red sandstone to a grand museum besides the pyramid, okay, for Ramses the Second. Okay, Ramses the Second has about 7 statues, but there is difference between the stone, 4 from red sandstone and 3 from granite. You know that the main source for granite is Aswan.
500 miles away.
But Ramses II collected many pieces from all Egypt and built his capital in Ramses, Ramesu, now contained about 35 kilometers. And now Germany mission worked there and continued. We have a French mission in this area, but the old man or the famous man, Philippe Ressou, who worked about 40 years in this area, we lost him. He changed. And the new director, new manager for this French mission, his name is Francois Leclerc. But he hasn't enough information. And because Corona, he stopped and left us to France. And we will start, okay? Now, Egyptian mission did excavation. And I will take you to see new excavation by Egyptian mission. It's very interesting. Okay, we'll start. A limestone. He the ma'at in it if he gave the offerings of ma'at to his father. Okay? And the Nebkha'u and this cartouche for Ramses II, the Lord of the Crowns. This limestone. Okay? For Ramses II. Okay. This Midi. And this is very deep. Midi the beloved four. Okay? And this Ka it means the soul. Okay. Soul.
So,
okay. But very deep.
Yes, Ramses.
Everything belonging to Ramses the Second discovery is very deep, like this. This Midi the bluff. Very interesting, very deep. Okay. This is the top of the ship of Amun. This is the top of the ship of Amun, okay? I think you have much time here.
Yes.
Okay. Because you finished the bustes, okay, we continue to 6 o'clock, no problem. We have much time here. And the Egyptian mission now, by restoration, will put this here, this is chapel, okay?
Can we'll I touch start. It?
Yeah. I think we have a statue here, but we lost it. This Geronit, okay? We put something here and collected the other with the other, this, okay? This pieces. Look here, and this here.
This is what you say. This is to. This is the new. This is modern
this is new restoration.
Restoration. Yeah.
Okay. To collect them together.
To put them together.
Together. Yes.
What do you put in between them? This like a dowel,
Something.
Stone.
To, yeah. From. something group and to collect it with the gazelle. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, the only big shark for Hathor in the form of cow. With the crown of Hathor, sun disk and the two feather and the two horns here. This Hathor. We can read the text. Jid me do in Hathor nibit nihit. Words or recitation is said by Hathor, the lady of Sikomara. The tree of Sikomara. You know? Mm-hmm. The tree of Sikomara? Okay. And this Hathor, the only form for Hathor as cow. As cow, okay? And this is his crown, okay? His crown. Many cartouches here from Ramses II. You know that each king in ancient Egyptian civilization have five titles. Birth name, coronation name, Nepti name, Huri name, and the Golden Horus name. Okay? And Ra, the son of the god Ra. Okay? And this birth name for Ramses II. Ra, Missu, Miri, Amen. Ra, the god of the sun. Okay? Miri, Amen, the beloved for the god Amen. What's the meaning of Amen? Well, madam, you know what's the meaning of Amen? This word, what mean?
Hidden.
God.
Yes, the hidden God. The hidden God. This as Ra, the sun. But Amen, oh, you will discover something. Ra is the opposite of Amen. You know, you understand me? And the opposite.
I don't.
What do you mean? Ra, the sun is the opposite. Because you see the sun, it's appearance.
Yes.
But you don't see.
But Amen, hidden.
Hidden. So they're like polar opposites.
Yeah, opposites.
Polarities.
Yes.
Amen is hidden. You don't see.
Ra is appear.
Amen is the essence that permeates all things around us. Ra is the sun.
Yes.
Okay. Essence of the sun.
Yeah, and the opposite. Amen and Ra. Okay.
Yes. And they're facing each other here. The opposites.
But what's the mean of miss?
Son of. Miss.
Yes,
son
miss.
Of.
It shall. Okay. But this meme mean the royal.
Nisu.
Misu. Through the royal. Like the royal king.
Yeah.
Okay. Atum itimu nib iyonu. Atum. What's the meaning of Adam? Adam, it means the complete. Complete or the full. Okay. Nib, the lord of iyonu. Iyonu, now Heliopolis, El Mataraya, and Shams. Okay. And this Miri. Okay. This black granite, black, not basalt, black granite. Okay, this is statue for Ramses II, okay, but restoration badly by the French mission. Okay, but we can read this text. This is double crown, white and red crown for this statue. But we can read this. This double crown, if you want to go back, okay. After Ramses II, coronation name and birth name, Sarah, okay, the Ankh gave life. Mi Ra, like the god of the sun, Jitta and Nahah.
For all eternity.
Yeah, for eternity, yes. But Jit eternity in the land. In
the land, because.
In the sky.
The land, the
yeah,
sky.
Yeah. And this is a symbol of land, Ta.
Ta.
Ta. Okay. And this Nahah, eternity in the heaven, in the sky. Okay. Yes, Ramses the second. Double crown.
This double crown. Amazing.
Yeah. If you want to take a madam, you can carry and move it towards you. The crown, yes.
Yeah.
As a crown for you.
I'll give my hat.
If you can carry.
Leave the hat, take the crown. Huh? Yeah, it's so smooth. It's amazing, the craftsmanship.
I just want to stay here and cuddle it.
Wow. This piece part from this statue.
From this statue.
Yes, yes. Okay. But maybe some people told me, maybe the Fertari, not sure. Maybe, but we are not sure now, the royal family. This original color. Original color. Okay. Sand, this can do to feather. Okay. And look here.
So this is red sandstone, is it?
Yeah, yeah. This Nebkhau and Persian name for Ramses the second. But we can read something. This 1005. This 1006. This is leg, the second part from his body.
1005, and that's 1006. Part 1006.
You can read it.
Yeah. This archaeological number.
Eight up there.
as this is new, we put the crown here.
You put the crown up?
Yes.
That wasn't always there. When did you put the crown up?
Yeah, about since 1 month.
Yeah, because we were here in September. You didn't have the crown up. That's brand new.
But it was here.
It was down below. Yeah.
But we put it up, okay?
This is brand new.
Very beautiful, very nice. Madam, maybe this statue, small, smile for you. A smile for you or not for you.
Okay. Smile for me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ramses II ruled about 67 years. He is a famous king in ancient Egyptian civilization. In each way, in every place, you will discover many statues, many obelisks for Ramses II. Okay? Okay, we can go here.
What are you using to hold it on top? Do you just put it on top, or is there in between a hole, like a dowel that holds it together?
Yeah. The Egyptian mission will start restoration.
Yeah.
We can't lift it like this, but restoration will complete.
You're not finished. You're going to complete it. You'll put in.
We didn't finish it.
No. Okay? Still working.
Yeah, yeah.
So there you have an exclusive update from Tanis. The crown has been restored.
Yeah. Look here. Yes, I will speak about that. Okay, no problem. Here Ramses II, madam, in front of the god Ra or Akhti. How you know? You can read his name here. Ra. Her Akhti. But by restoration, we lost something. Ra. We lost Ra. Ra here was here. But restoration, this is new. By Egyptian mission. Ra or Akhti. But birth name, Ra. Missu Midi Amin Ramses II. Wasser.
Ma'at.
Ma'at. Ra. Sitib. Wasser the strong. Ma'at, goddess of justice. Ra. Sitib in Ra. Choosing from the god Ra. This coronation name for Ramses II. And this, Jid Midu in Rahur Akhti. Recitation or words said by the god Rahur Akhti. D-N-I-N-X, I will give you was and Ankh. Will you give power and Ankh? Maybe not only the life. Maybe it means eternity. When the god gave it for the king, maybe it means eternity, not only life. Okay, then the god Rahur Akhti was Atifi crown. This Atifi crown. Ramses II, and this Nechich. Yeah. In the festival of Hepset. Okay?
What does it do? What's its purpose?
What?
What does she saying, like the function? Why would they use that?
To move something like this.
Like the chaff, the wheat,
clean something or move something, okay?
Nakaka, more commonly known as the flail, and often associated with a crook, also called the heka, was a reoccurring motif and symbol used in ancient Egyptian society. Originally an attribute of Osiris, it became an insignia of pharaonic authority. The flail stood as a symbol for fertility of the land. There are different theories on its significance. Some Egyptologists believed it was used as a symbol of the ruler's coercive power. As the shepherd of his flock, the ruler encouraged his subjects as well as restrained them. But E.A. Wallace Budge believed that the flail was used to thresh grain. There are more esoteric explanations and a connection to Masonic symbolism, but this is the subject for another video. Let's get back into the tour.
But you look here, Ramses II as a young man, okay? With this cobra and this crown, okay? And this...
It's a minute?
Yes,
no, not a minute. Okay. Necklace?
Yeah. Necklace, okay? Okay, now we'll go to this important thing for Ramses II.
Largest statue. Largest single stone statue remains. Would have been
Madam,
largest.
You can consider this piece part from the huge statue, the largest statue in ancient Egyptian civilization. But we have only about three pieces only. But we lost the other pieces. Okay? You can imagine this huge statue about 28 meters up.
It would have been taller than the Colossus of Memnon, taller than the Ramses.
The largest one from the Ramsium.
Yeah, bigger. This would have been bigger.
Bigger, yes. This is bigger. But we have only about three pieces from this statue. Okay?
Where's the other two pieces, Ezzat?
We lost it.
You lost it. So you only have this one piece? Three. It's the other two. Oops.
One, two, three. One, two, three. But we lo-
here, this Shashang, this here.
So wait, this is the one, this is the second, two
that's here.
And three, that's the third piece.
And this is the coronation name. What's the huge?
Wusser.
Wusser, Ma'at, Ra.
Ra. Wusser, Ma'at, Ra.
Okay. This is the coronation name for them, see the second, his name, okay? For the huge statue, okay. This car,
wait, what was this one you said? Why did they put this one? This wasn't part of it.
Speak about it. This is different.
Yeah, different.
Maybe this white granite, this red granite.
Right, white granite,
different,
red
different
granite.
Different in this tune, okay. But I will speak about important thing for you, madam. The kings of the 21st and the 22nd dynasty, not Egyptian kings, but Libyan. Libyan kings.
Libyan kings.
Libyan. 21st and 22nd dynasty. And you visited Bubastis.
Like Siwa. Yeah. Yeah, Siwa Oasis.
From the west of Egypt. Okay. But the famous king, or the important king in the 22nd dynasty, which is capital Bubastis, is Shashang the First. Why? Because he went to Palestinian and damaged the temple. And brought the three jars of the Prophet Sulaiman, peace be upon him.
The three jars
of the Prophet Sulaiman. And the Ark of Moses. So many Goshen people, or the children of Israel, try to say that maybe we discover the tomb of Shashang the First in this area. Why? Why? Because the kings of the 22nd dynasty and Bubastis, it chose this area to build their tombs. Like Shashang the Third, like Usirkun the Second. So maybe, we are not sure, maybe we discovered his tomb in this area.
Right.
In Tanis. Okay? And this Shashang the Third. But you will notice something. Before his name, they put cartouches for Ramses. Look, Wasser, Ma'at, Ra, Sitib and Ra. This coronation name for Ramses. After Miri Emin Sabastet Shashank. But this Miri Emin Shashank and the Sabastet. Okay? Neter Heka Ayonu. Neter Heka Ayonu, this title for Shashank the Third. Neter, or Nature, it means the God. Heka, the ruler. Okay? Ayonu, Hayobles, El Mataraya. Okay, this Shashang the Third with his
Montu
crown. In the middle, this son, Iba Montu, was to face.
Shokran. They receive in life.
Yeah. Maybe the God or Uzir give him life. To give him the life, okay, for him. Okay.
Shokran.
Okay, the second piece. This is the piece. Ka Nacht, the strong bull.
Kamutel, the bull of his mother, Luxor, bull of his mother, strong bull.
This title for Ramses the Second. Ka, it means the bull. Kanach, the strong bull. Strong bull. Okay, and this is the third beast from this statue. Okay, from Jeroni. Okay. Here, this lintel, maybe this lintel. Miri Ozir, Ka, in Set.
Set.
Why Ramses the Second collected between two brothers? You know that Set killed his brother Uzir. Why? Ramses the Second wanted to say that I did peace in the ground, in the earth, and the bears in the heathen. I collected between two brothers. Okay? Ramses the Second. Montu, the god of war, Sa, this picture from Montu. You see this clown? Like this. Okay? Montu Sa, Montu Ir Em Chibish If. He did it by his
strength.
Yes.
If.
Okay. Maybe this thing. Ir Em Chibish If. Okay. This is the triad. Ramses the Second in the middle between the god Rahur Akhti in the left, and you can read his name, and right, Bitah Tartinin. How you name? You can follow me to read it. Tatinin. The god of the earth. Of the earth. Okay? Bitah. Tatinin. Tinin. Good?
Good. Tamam.
Okay. Miri bitah. Miri etimu. Miri i'ah. I'ah? What mean i'ah?
Ah.
I'ah.
Ah.
The moon.
The moon. So these two. Is the moon.
Yes. The oldest god for the moon. But Khonsu is the new. He take everything from Yah and become the big one, Khonsu. But the first god for moon is Yah. Birth name and coronation name Zid. But look, Sarah. Three rock on the left and three rock on the right. Symmetry. And this in the middle, separated here. Look, madam. Sarah, look. See, look here. And see, look here, okay? Miri Khebiri. Miri Atimu. Miri Rahurakhti. Okay? Or Ramses the second. You can read his name here. Miri Rahurakhti again. Miri Rahurakhti. Okay? And this Huri name. I told you each king have five titles. This Huri Her Ka Rakht Miri Ma'at. And this madam, Nisut BT, the king of Upper and Lower Egypt, Ramses the second, Sarah. Okay? Okay. Now, madam, you can watch, you can see here remains for five temples. The first temple is Amun, Amun temple. And his wife, Mut. Okay? The third is Khonsu. Amun, Mut, Khonsu, Ertriad, like Luxor. You can consider this area as Kabi from Luxor, North Luxor. The same design, the same applying. Even we discovered that the axis of the temple of Amun from the west to east, like El Karnak. The entrance of the temple of Amun, the main temple here, from the west to east, like El Karnak. Amun, Mut, Khonsu, in addition to Horus temple and Eastern temple. Eastern temple. And we have here two sacred lakes.
Yes.
The French mission Pierre Monte in 1948 discovered the forest beside in the end of the temple of Amun. Okay. But the French mission by Philippe Bristow discovered the second sacred lake in 2009 by Philippe Bristow. But he covered it. But only me who have about 100 pictures for this secret lake. Very interesting, very beautiful. Original car like Luxor and Karnak. But he was afraid from Egyptian, from thieves. So he covered it again. We will go. We'll go after. Okay. This is the main statue for Ramses the second. But madam, you will notice something. His features, not Ramses. Amnemhat. Middle Kingdom. But Ramses the second, he used it for himself. Okay?
What's he holding?
This maybe
I was thinking it might have been an egg, but
maybe and the great chef maybe something in his as a protection for himself.
Like a saw protection.
Yeah. Okay? Something
this
to protect
the rope. One for us.
Yes, this Ramses here, one for the sound and one for the.
Yeah, it's like the saw, right? The saw, protect the rope.
I keep it, but I can speak it by English.
Yes, it's okay.
Mashi. I will speak about it after.
Mashi, it's okay.
Is there a one for us on this side?
Yeah, for us.
Not on the other side.
Yeah.
We discovered not just for Ramses, but Ramses used it for himself. And the Egyptian mission, it was for divided for pieces or broken for pieces, but the Egyptian mission collected it in one complete statue for Ramses the second. By Egyptian mission, not by a French mission. This is the gate which built by Shashang the Third. Shashang the Third did four things here. Built his gate here, okay? And he rearranged the temple and built a tomb for himself and built well there. We discovered many important cartouches. Madam, you can follow me to discover to read these cartouches. Important cartouches here. Okay. The number of the 21st dynasty, which was here in this madam, was seven kings. Seven. Okay? But the founder or the first king in the 21st dynasty is Semendis. And if now we didn't discover his tomb, but we have cartouche for himself. Hitch, Khibir, Ra, Sitib, and Ra. Hitch, Khibir, Ra, Sitib, and Ra. The second name for this king, like Ramses the second. That's the second name for Ramses, Sitib, and Ra. Okay, we have only cartouche for this king. Okay, we'll move to this king. This important cartouche, madam, this cartouche concerning Cheops Khufu. You know Khufu, madam? Khufu, over the big pyramid, Cheops, okay? But we can read this cartouche. Nisut Piti, the king of Abra and Egypt, Nibti, to ladies, Nibti, okay? Wajid and Rekhbet, and Midjidir, this title or Nibti name for Cheops Khufu. Unusual thing here, Nisubiti inside cartouche. Usually Nisubiti outside cartouche. Yeah. This is the first. If we believe this cartouche concerning Cheops, you can consider this beast the oldest beast, the oldest lintel, the oldest obelisk in this area. Why?
Because that's an obelisk.
Maybe. We are not sure. Maybe. Okay? Why? Because all the kingdom for dynasty. Okay.
So they would have taken, Isa, they would have taken this stone from the old kingdom sites and brought it to Tanis?
Yeah. Ramses II, who collected it from many places, from Cairo, yeah, and they built his capital in Bir Ramses II. After this capital damaged, the king of the 21st moved everything.
Why do the academics, archaeologists say that they moved it? Was the flooding in Thebes?
Why? Because to go to Luxor is far away.
Yeah.
So it's good for me, for the kings, to remove it from Kantir, about 35 kilometers from this place, and built it here. Mm. But difficult to go to Luxor. Okay. This evidence that Ramses II reused many pieces for himself. He omitted something and put his title to put his cartouche. W? What? Okay. And Nibtawi. Nib-ir-chit. What's the meaning of Nib-ir-chit? Nibtawi, the Lord of two lands, Upper Egypt and the Lower. Nib-ir-chit, it means the Lord of the rituals. Rituals. Nib-ir-chit. And the coronation name was Ramat Ra Siti Barra and the Sar is Ramses. This is a big cartouche for Ramses II. Very big cartouche. And look here, this lentil and this lentil. And best nature, Nifer Ra in Kemet, Itimu, Anch, in Rechit, Nisut, Peter, Ramses II. Kemet repeated here about 5 times.
Where? The top one or the middle? Oh, I'm not.
This.
The middle.
From the first. Nature?
Nefer? Nature, Nefer.
Ra.
Ra.
In Kemet.
In Kemet.
Kemet, Egypt.
Yeah, Kemet, Egypt. The owl is usually the
M. Upside down.
Where?
Upside.
Oh,
upside down.
Yeah, I see. There it is. Net.
Upside down. Upside down.
Kemet, okay? Nature.
Kemet, it means black land or black soil.
Black soil, black land.
Okay. And this important cartouche for Shoshang the First, who spoke about him that he went to Palestine. And he upside down. Shoshang. Look. And the lime stone. Okay, now let's stop. This is the hall. This is the gate. Okay, we should be watching that here. And we discovered about 6 columns here, okay, with bamboo tree crowns. Bamboo tree crowns. Okay, and this is very important. The son of the famous son for Ramses II. Okay, maybe the prophet Moses lived in the time of two kings or two pharaohs. The first is Ramses, and the second is the son very important. But we are not sure who is the pharaoh of Moses. What's the name of Moses? This word mean
Mrs.
Mu, it means water. Sa, the son of the water. Who brought him from the water. From the water.
The water, the primordial water, noon.
Yes. And maybe the prophet Moses was in Kantir. We are not sure. But there is a problem.
Right.
Maybe this is afraid from
the second is a funeral.
I kept it. Now, I don't agree with the concept that Allah or God or the Creator destroyed the site, but you can find references in the Bible by Ezekiel about getting fire to Zoan. I'm more inclined to believe that the destruction is the result of man. Matt Simpson at the Ancient Architects YouTube channel offers a plausible explanation, claiming that it could be the result of Greek fire. I will leave a link to his video in the description below.
What is this? Ezzat, in Egyptology, the bread, is there the name for the bread? How would you say bread?
As offering.
This is not,
the God.
Okay,
as offering for the God. Okay? Now we'll go to the well. Madam, we'll go to the well. As the Major. We're not here. Six columns here.
Please. She's okay, it's mesh. Let's go.
Yeah, no problem.
If the flood of the River Nile is up, you will pay many taxes for your country. If the flood is low, you a few taxes from the people to our country, the other government. Okay, but if everyone have stairs, if you want to enter to see, but as the ancient Egyptian people collected between this stone, limestone, without anything in the middle. Look, we saw it as in there.
No mortar, nothing in the middle, it's just stone. Yeah, no, stone by stone.
Okay. Yes, stone by stone. And this, in the corner, to protect the well from earthquake.
To protect nilometers from earthquakes implies knowledge of previous earthquakes, which may hint at some of the destruction on site. There have been several known catastrophic earthquakes. In fact, ancient Egypt experienced several back in those days. In the Byzantine era, Tanis was thought to have been shaken up by a violent earthquake, which is probably the most likely contender for destroying the giant statues, which date back to the 21st century and are reused from Ramses. Though destruction may have been caused in the 7th century, sometime between 1168 and 1169, during the Crusades.
Very, very good. In the corner, to protect the world from earthquake. And there's just only one who is this in the corner to protect the well. Okay? And everyone, if you want to look upstairs at the book here, look on this well. Okay. This well is very good. And if you want to enter and start by the stairs, take some picture, put it, no problem. It's very good, very interesting.
The stairs over there.
We can go.
Ezzat, I'm sure you probably got this from other people that come. You know, there's a lot of people on the internet that think that Tanis is much older and lost. What's your take on all of that? As an Egyptologist and somebody who works here on the site, what is your take on this idea that Tanis is much, much older and that this was all destroyed, you know, before the Egyptians?
Yes. It's very good idea. But a few people come to visit us here.
here because the way not good. And you need studies people who know it. But it's very important area. Maybe the land of Goshen. It's in the land of Goshen. Very important for the children of Israel, for the Goshen, for the Goshen people. Very important. But who read about it? You need a specialist to read about Tanis.
So a lot of the people that say that or put the stuff on YouTube are not, you're saying they're not specialists, that yes. They're just making these ideas without knowing everything, without having the context. There's all lagoon, there's all a marsh, it was all swampland geologically long time ago, right?
Yeah. Not many people wrote about Tanis, but I have many magister and doctorate books in my office, but by Arabic.
In Arabic, not in English. Not and a lot of
but
the...
But you can take it or I will give you my number of telephone and send it in the WhatsApp and translate in any...
to English, Arabic to English.
It's pretty good for you, pretty useful.
Yeah, and Mama Kalinch Arabi, Shwaya Arabi, English for me.
Look, it's pretty good if you want to interest.
Yeah, let me go down to see. Shukran.
My friend, I hope that I go to America to work here to see America and to come back. I have passport, but I haven't money.
No falus. Mafish falus. Mafish bakshish.
If I have enough money, yeah. I can go to America. Do I have passport?
Yeah. When you go to America, I'll show you the archaeological sites in America. I live in Luxor. I moved from America to Luxor. I've resident. Yeah.
How is the Egyptian collected stone by stone? It's not a stone, not anything in the middle. It's a limestone.
No limestone, or no mortar in between. Just
no cement.
Look how close, how tight that is, line by line.
Maybe 10 meters?
Yeah, 10 meters high, maybe.
If we dig, if you would dig in the ground, you will face underground water. And this is a problem. It was very salt. This is a problem for the limestone. Maybe damaged or broken it. So we stopped. Yeah.
Ezzat, how far down is the water level? Do you know? How many meters below?
Maybe 3 meters or 5 meters.
Oh, that's it, huh? 3 to 5 meters below, maybe. You can see. Pottery, pot shards.
Which one?
Yes.
Look up. Ramses in the front of the Gadrahti. After this mean pit. Pit, it means the sky. Pit like this. It means the sky. After Hurini. Her was double crown. Horus was double crown. Do you see? Okay, after this here, we say it in Ka Nacht Sa'itumu. The strong bull and the son of the god at Atum. This holy name for Ramses. Nisubiti Ramses II, Hawita city who destroyed the Nuba.
Nuba. What's Nuba? Nubia.
Okay. Nubia. And there.
Where? Which one is for Nubia?
After Cartouche Ramses II, someone catch something. This is how we.
Sitted. Nubia.
Sitted. Okay. This is sitted. And this is the symbol of foreign country. Maybe we didn't discover it before this time. We damaged it like this. Okay? The Egyptian mission moved colored obelisks, the important and very tall one, to a grand museum.
The museum.
And they left the broken.
They left
the bed.
Yeah, at the site.
Like this, the second. Look. The sun. Rimboot half many years. Rimboot. Yes. Okay. This will be the second one. Which Ramses II? Okay.
Sarah.
Mia Hesi. The lion. The strong lion. Okay. Nish Niti Fich Fif Shasu. The land of Shesu. It is a symbol of the country. Ta, fich or khif. You can read it fich or khif. Ta, Shesu, the land of Shesu. Okay. Haq, Sa'ri, Haq, you and Sa'ri. Who damaged the mountain of Sa'ri? Okay. Im khibish if by his hand. As a skin, strong, nipta, we don't see the second. One temple have ten obelisks. Okay? But the number of the obelisks is important. The text here for you and for me and for the archaeologists. After Ramses II, he wrote something here. Inu, Wiru, Retinu. Did you good? Inu, Oprot, Wiru, the greeters, people who brought the very important people, okay? The greeters, people. Greet men, greeters. Syria. Okay. This is a symbol of foreign country, Khasut. Syria.
So he brought Syria. The.
He brought them. M. Sikir Anch as cavitus, as a prisoner like this. Look here. He holds something here with his hand, like this.
Mm-hmm.
As cavitus. You know captive?
Captive, yeah.
Captive, yes, yes. Captive. As a prisoner.
Prisoner, okay. Yeah.
You have brought them
Nubian,
as
Syrians, the enemies of Egypt, foreigners.
Many enemies. Okay?
Nine bows.
Ta'in Khita, who damaged or collapsed or broken the land of Khita Hittites. This is Ta, the land, okay? But bit who didn't exist, okay? Bit Ta'in Khita, who damaged or broken or collapsed the land of Hittites.
The Hittites. He destroyed the Hittites.
Yeah. And the only obelisk which have five titles for Ramses II. There is a name, coronation name, native name, holy name. The only obelisk.
Ah.
Okay. But not complete one. And you can read Kemet here. Kemet. Look here. Yes. This Nipti, Wajit, and the Nikhbet. Mek Kemet. Who protect Egypt?
Me?
Mek.
Mik
meme M.
Yeah.
Mik
K.
Mik Kemet. Mik Kemet. Who protect? Who protect Egypt from enemy? Okay. And this Kemet KMT, the symbol of Egyptian city.
Yeah.
Who protect Egypt? Okay. Wa'if Khasut, and destroyed or broken the enemies, the foreigners. Ramses II in front of the god Atum, and Atum gave him Khibish as gift. Okay? And Ramses here, polite or punishment one enemy here. He's just to kill him. Okay. Punishment is Tella. Or polite is Tella. Okay. This is about 30 pieces. We can go after 30 pieces from complete statue from Red Sandstone from Ramses II. We will go, but after we finish this. Okay. This
is from Ramses II?
Yeah. The complete one at Louvre Museum.
At the Louvre Museum. The head.
Here, important statue for Ramses, but you can stand here. Mm-hmm. Pierre Monte, French archaeologist, has discovered four statues for Ramses II in the second pylon. Okay? From red sandstone. It tall about 8 meters. And usually Ramses II put his Egyptian wife in the side and the foreign wife on the other side. Okay? And this statue is very important. Why? Because Ramses II is the first man who held the first peace treaty in the world. After the Battle of Kadesh.
Kadesh.
And after this battle, he did economic or politic marriage. Okay? He brought the daughter of the Hittites, of the Lord of Hittites, and he married it. And he gave her all Egyptian titles. And we can read. Hemet Nusut Warit. Hemet, the great royal wife. Hemet wife. Nisut royal, Werit, the great. The great royal wife, Hinut Tawi. Hinut Tawi, the lady of two lands, Upper Egypt and the Lower Egypt. Okay. And put her name in cartouche like Egyptian queens. Mat Her Nifirura. This is her name. Nifir, beautiful. Nifiru, Lura. Like Nefertari, Nefertiti. Okay. Saat is for female. Okay. The daughter Ba'a'in Khita. The daughter of the king, of the great man who of Hittites, the symbol of foreign country. And look here. She is very tall. And he put her hand behind him as support. Why? Because she's foreign wife, not Egyptian one. Okay, she put her hand as support for him. In the other side, and this coronation name and the birth name for Ramses II and the Sarah, the son of the god Ra. Okay, this look. The other side. Merit Amun, which he used to granite statue, busted, but he from red sandstone. Saat Nisu, Hemet Nisu.
it has two means, not one. Saat, the daughter, royal daughter. And royal wife in the same time. So some people thought maybe think royal daughter. Go?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay. You have much time to five or two?
Yeah, we have time. It's okay.
We open to 6 o'clock. Okay. But don't forget to change my money. Don't
yes, you? Yeah.
Okay. This piece concerning Mary Ra. This would be the king of all the world. Okay. Mary, this Mary, Ra, the beloved for the god Ra, is Bibi, 6th dynasty. Okay? And this Nebti, Wajit and Nechbet. Mary, Ghit. Mary in Ghit. Ghit, it means part of his body. Part from his body. Okay? And this Hur, Hur, Nibu,
gold.
Yes. And this, maybe this Dandara, the city of Dandara, Basa Bibi, son of Dandara. Okay, and the Dian Khneb, but we'll look at it. This is all the kingdom, 6th dynasty. Okay.
Six dynasty.
Here. Ha-ka-ra, Sun-sert, Middle Kingdom. And here, Mary Uzir. Look, Mary and Uzir. This Uzir. Mary Uzir. Okay. This, Si-Amun. He was king in the 21st dynasty. You have all the kingdom. New king, Middle Kingdom, and this little period. Little period. Okay. And here, God of Fertility, Amun mean. Amun mean who gave this, okay? Amun pain, okay? It's biggest sharp for Amun. But this important cartouche for Neter Khibir Ra Setep N Amen. Who? Si Amun. Important. Sa Ra. But he changed. Not the duck. But it means Sa Ra. The son of the god Ra. But he changed it.
No duck.
The place, no duck.
Yeah.
Okay. And he, Sarah, Miri Emin. Si Amun, Miri Amun. This cartouche for Si Amun. But it's important. Nature, Khibir, Ra, Sitib, in Emin, choosing from the god Amun. The god of fertility, Amun mean. Okay? This bitah. This mut maybe, or this double crown, it can be etemu.
Etemu when it has a double crown?
Yes.
Or it might
like
be
man, mood. Like man, but with this double crown. Okay?
Or it could
this,
be
city, the second, not city, the first. Not father of Ramses. City, Mary in Betah. This city. You can read it, city. City, what's the meaning of city? Who belong or concerning the city? Part from city.
Of city.
Yeah, city. Mary in Betah, Mahubetah, Diyanch. Okay, and Neb Khaou, Neb Tawi, coronation, Neb. This city, again here. City. Okay, we can lift this, okay. No problem. Maybe this is still like 14 stella in Cairo Museum. As coronation for Ramses, the second in front of the gods. Okay, but we collected it by Egyptian mission, a restoration. You can take your time here, much time here, and after we will speak with the policeman to take you to Eastern Temple and West Temple, okay, to take some permission for yourself, and I will take you, after I finish, to go to a new excavation.
Okay.
But no photo in the excavation.
Okay? No photo in a new excavation? Okay.
We have 30 pieces. What 30 pieces? But look here, his mouth, his face, very beautiful, his lab. Yeah. This is a crown, okay? But I want to speak about this and lift you to the mosque.
Okay.
All this. Here, Ramses II, we can read the 6th.
نسوت بيتي the king of upper and lower Egypt نبتوي the lord of two lands وسر معت رع ستب إن رع رمسيس the second سا رع نبخعو the lord of رمسيس the second here رمسيس the second give wine and the milk to the god رع wine and the milk okay did Erib will give offerings to the god and this is the plural six two Okay, I'll bear the name and the coronation name for Ramses II. This is the god Ra, very beautiful. With the sun, come here. The god Ra. And his was and the Ankh.
Was.
Here, Etimu, Atum. With double crown as man and the Ankh and was in his hand. And the Egyptian mission who work here discovered this stella here in this place. But it was covered with sand, but we discovered it and put it here. You can you take
what time. Year? When did you when?
In this place.
No, not where. When? How many years ago?
About 2 years ago.
2 years ago.
2 years,
so this is new.
A few from this time. Okay. This at you can you take a photo here. Muhammad, who are you taking to the Shari? You bust a little here. You bust the Holy Mount. Khonsu, Horus, and we're going to salute to Egypt.
Yeah. So this is most Khonsu.
Khonsu on this side, on this side.
Khonsu and
Horus. He's still on this side, and the Horus temple on this side.
And where's the sacred lakes?
Sacred lake beside this
Khonsu.
And the policeman, no. He knows. Mr. Muhammad. Mr. Muhammad.
Egyptologist, Mr. policeman.
Egyptologist. Because he work with me,
yeah,
so he
knows.
Learned from me.
Yeah, he learned from okay, you, the great Egyptologist.
Yeah, Egyptologist, yes, yes. And I'll have a face, he'll go to Imam Khonsu, and the Holy Mount, he'll go to Sacred Lake. The Holy Mount, and the Holy Mount, he'll go to Take photo in the Eastern Temple, for yeah. And go to the mosque and come back quickly for
you. Okay, mesh.
Goodbye.
Shukran. I just gonna.
Our tour was cut short when Ezzat explained his adoration for his religion and how he prays five times a day. This was not my first time to Tanis, nor was it the first time Ezzat bounced mid-tour in favor of such, and I must say that I admire his discipline. So while Ezzat dips out to mosque, I continue to take a look at some of the fragmentary stones on display. If you are watching this as part of your own hieroglyphic study, you can pause the video to examine the reliefs. Otherwise, enjoy the walkthrough. I also visited other temples, such as Khonsu and Horus at Tanis, in addition to the sacred lakes and new excavations as part of the bonus footage available only for Patreon supporters on Patreon or members of my Ancient Egypt Mystery Schools, which you can become a member of. To learn more, visit ancientegyptmysteryschools.com. While more remains to be dug up, there's so much more to see at Tanis. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and leave a comment below. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe and don't forget to click the bell icon to receive notifications when new videos like this one are uploaded. And finally, if you are interested in seeing Tanis, consider joining one of my Adept Expeditions tours made available at adeptexpeditions.com. Thank you for watching.